which is
only two.
Well, startling amount. Just ridiculous. We also have one on the other team.
Can't believe there's two whole peaches.
It's actually, oh no, it's George Mason University, not UMD.
Yep.
No, look, two peaches on each side.
Alright.
Jeez, here we go. We got Bay and Hero.
I think this is just a warm-up because they didn't even strike yet. So, yeah. Alright, we're starting off with a hand warmer. So, welcome. This is George Mason University versus University of Delaware. So, each of these guys are going to be going at it. That should be 20, not 2. Uh-oh, that could be a problem. crap. Alright, I'll fix that shortly. Which score are we missing? Left player.
Oh shoot, my name doesn't even make it onto the commentator list. Whatever.
Oh yeah. Vince, please. Okay, let's do this. Okay, we gotta up the width here. I don't remember if that's height or width that I'm adjusting.
Yeah, you got it.
Oh, okay, good.
It kind of goes off, but it's fine.
Yeah, it's fine for now, so.
Who won TMG? Peach Hype?
Okay, I think we're mostly good to go. Let's jack the... Let's put this down to a... Alright. Okay, we'll be starting off on Battlefield,
oh,
and they're
wow.
good to go. Okay.
Oh, Peach going in.
Wow, BMC coming out strong right now.
Jeez.
Delaware showing there not to be messed with. So Delaware's running strong for their boy Billy right now. I'm assuming that's BMC. It's probably his initials or something. So,
Possible. Let's see. Ooh.
Alright, strong start for those guys.
Only 32%.
So for those of you who don't know, melee games, rule set, basically the two starting players pick from the five neutral stages, do a normal stage striking procedure, and then whoever they send in after that can counterpick to any stage they want, and there's no bans, and there's no character switching. So all the teams have to lock in their characters in advance. They have to submit their rosters to me by midnight, the day before the crew battle. And then, great edge guard.
Oh, gee.
Wow, BMC off to a great start.
So weak.
So, yeah. This is crazy.
Oh, my God.
Delaware is just coming out really strong. Ultima Scout said, you know, if you're only worried about Yuan, then,
They just put in their strong.
You're ignoring some real problems, so maybe this is what he was talking about.
I'm scared we're not going to see it. We're not going to see everyone on Delaware's side. Look at this.
Yeah, GMU's got a few pocket falcons, so I'm sure they're thinking of using one of them at this point.
Is this going to be a four stock? It's going to be four stock for the first game?
Yeah, this is crazy. I might have been sleeping on Delaware.
No.
You're looking very strong right now. Strong up there.
Jeez.
Bob Marvin for SG. Okay, good tip for F Smash. So he manages to take at least one stock, and sometimes that's really all you need. Just kind of shakes off the nerves a little bit. So, especially when you feel like you got your whole team.
Yeah, momentum might be in their favor now.
He's playing a good defensive game right now, and BMC, as I say that, starts pulling turnips. I was gonna say he wasn't pulling too many. That's how you can really gain control. If you see a Marth that's retreating, you know.
They're definitely playing passive. Yeah. Not, I think Peach playing definitely a little bit more aggressive, pushing out a little bit more. Getting those dash attacks in is definitely gonna.
This could be a big edge guard though. Oh, that's a huge nair.
That might be it.
I think he saw his jump.
Oh, there it is. The first game, only one stock away from Delaware.
So good stuff. GMU down to 16, Delaware down to 19. So GMU has counter pick advantage. I wonder if they're gonna use one of their good Captain Falcons already.
I guess the Peach. I would assume so. I want to see the up airs.
They got a.
GGG. It's not over yet.
Captain Falcon player. Looks like they're deliberating right now, trying to figure out who to send in. And it looks like it is going to be Duckpimp coming in right now.
Can't wait to see some. Some style.
As I expected. So, I know Ryan pretty well. He's definitely got a very.
It looks like they have a CPU
very
standard.
Strong Falcon. So.
There it is. Oh, he's going Captain Fabulous. I'm ready. Personal
Ultimate Scout says probably a bad idea. I wouldn't recommend it. Are you talking about sending a Falcon in against Peach? Well, we'll see.
Wouldn't
Interesting
recommend
choice
it.
Of
the up airs are
this might just be a hand warmer.
The fancy way off. Here we go.
But maybe Duck Pimp just... I think Duck Pimp, I remember hearing him say that he really just likes the stage, so...
There we go.
Personal preference can be a big thing.
Tries to get the hard read of the front smash.
Alright.
Well, Captain Valiant's really got to do here is get her in the air.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, and there
get
comes
those
the
big combos going. Oh, that knee was so close.
The knee.
Duck Pimp just trying to feel it out right now. Going for a grab. Set up that down throw to kill combo.
Misses a knee again.
Oh, oh,
she's, up in the, she's up in the air now. This is another knee.
Ooh, good aggression coming out from Duck Pimp right now. Yeah. Spacing his attacks well, but he's gone for a lot of these grabs that he's whiffed, and that's costing him. This could be a big edge guard.
Oh, that might, that's a stock. That's
rough.
Stock.
BMC coming out so strong right now.
Yeah, especially with a Peach Falcon.
I definitely didn't know. I feel like Duck Pimp really would have benefited more from a flatter stage like FD or Pokemon, even though Battlefield is a preference of his.
Duck Pimp is definitely missing a lot of these grabs, which is costing him a lot of percent.
Yeah, it almost looks like he's starting to throw out moves. He's not getting enough secure kills here. There we
finally
go. There's a strong
knee. There it is. Taking a stock off. Already at 52%. Is that a disadvantage? Good combo from Peach to the stomp.
I guess another advantage of a stage like this over FD is that Peach can't get the chain grabs on Falcon as easily.
That's so true.
Duck Pimp sneaks into the ledge though. Oh,
risky.
Yeah, he really just caught him attacking way too riskily up onto the stage. So. I feel like Duck Pimp's just whiffed way too many moves though.
Yeah, especially the grabs. He's not. Oh.
Trying to feel this Peach out, but it's giving him a really hard time.
Yeah,
oh my
he's
goodness.
Definitely
that down smash.
Definitely keeping, not giving him any advantages, never not giving him any opportunities to even do anything.
This could be a big
grab.
That's got to be a kill. Oh, oh my goodness. Slightly off
air,
on the spacing.
Countering it. Whiffs it, but gets the grab. That might be a stop.
All right, good recovery. Oh, great recovery.
Oh, gets the knee too.
Good conversion.
Off the ledge.
Gotta feel good having the lead now.
Yeah.
This could be big.
This could.
Great neutral.
Oh,
that was such a good
read the DI, and that front smash might do it.
Yep.
All right.
Takes a stock. All right. If Duck Pimp can take this stock, it'll be big. I'll keep them at only a 3-stock disadvantage.
Yeah. Could not execute on that whiff down smash. Oh.
This could lead to a good edge guard though. Oh,
the grab.
Back throw that had to be a whiff.
Happy input error. And no.
The nerves coming into play right now. Crazy.
Oh,
this could be it.
Too aggressive.
Oh, my gosh, how did that knee not connect?
Okay,
Duck Pimp in control
this
right now.
This might be it. Oh, and the back air brings
Duck
it in.
Pimp. Wow. That was crazy. Right. But he just waited for just the right moment. What's up? So good stuff to Duck Pimp. Holding off, making sure that BMC doesn't extend its lead anymore. So,
are people ordering DP Dough?
People are ordering DP Dough, so if you want to get in on that, go ahead and do that.
I am going to get on. I'll be right back.
All right, not sure who Delaware is going to be sending in next. They're deliberating. Now, I wouldn't be surprised if BMC and Yuan were their strongest players, unless there's yet someone else I'm sleeping in on. They're sleeping on, so we'll see who they send out. I know they got another Peach in their arsenal. Probably not going to send it against the Falcon. I think this is Snacks, if I'm not mistaken. One sec.
What was your tag?
Yep, this is Snacks. Or Snacks, I guess I should say, since he has an exclamation point at the end. So, Delaware going with Snacks. I believe a Fox player, if I'm not mistaken. Let's check on Facebook. Yep, Snacks is locked into Fox for today. So, no, Duck Pimp does in fact exist outside of Smash Bros. Also known as Flamingo. I sound like Snacks. Dude, I love Snacks. That's funny. I'll have to talk to him and see if I think I sound like him later. All right. Fountain of Dreams, the obvious counter pick here. Definitely one of Captain Falcon's weakest stages. So.
3, 2, 1, go!
And they're off. Duff Pimp gets the first opening, but they both kind of go back to neutral. Snack's trying to feel him out. Ooh, Duckbit might have some tricks on these platforms here. Saw a couple of edge cancels from him already. Interesting. I'm really interested to see who takes the first stock. Well, I guess it would be the only stock in Duckbit's case, but I feel like an opening here for Duckbit could be really big and give him a lot of momentum. Oh, a huge knee! Messes up the gentleman, but he got the reverse on it. Just going for this kill right now. Oop, this could be big edge guard. Oh my goodness. Flying around the stage, and that's going to be it. Big stock from Snacks. Snacks with the smacks. How's it going, Whittle? No, that's fine. Okay. How? Sweet. All right, we got an Insta TMG overlay. How about that? All right, hold on a sec. Wait. All right, I don't know who the Samus guy's tag is, but they didn't wait for me. I know that he is called Samus.
Definitely not Ultima Scout.
Definitely not. It's actually Ultima Scout, though. That's the secret. Crap, overlays. All right, the Samus from GMU is Ink.
Okay. He's actually apparently really good.
He is really good. He shows up to Cypherfest a lot. Really chill guy.
He beat Mike at the Arcadian at Clarendon.
Okay. Yeah. He's really good.
God damn it, Tom.
Thank you, Tito.
I told you I had an overlay.
Yeah, you did. I just didn't know if it was going to break anything or whatever. So.
Sorry.
12. All right.
What are the schools commentators? Why aren't they here talking trash?
I asked them, but they didn't step up.
Wow. Why would you not
Delaware
want to talk
is trash? Really impressing me.
Yeah, no,
I have to admit, I was sleeping on them big time.
They have a five-stock lead?
Five-stock lead.
Jesus.
Now, UMD does still have Altex and
GMU.
GMU still has Altex and Hyperflame. Definitely two of their stronger players. So.
True.
Yeah, Delaware definitely making GMU sweat right now.
Making MDVA sweat. Oh, please. UMD is sitting comfy right now. With our DP Dome sponsorship.
Ooh, this could be big.
Oh, nice tech.
Yeah, great tech from Sax. Staying alive here. The approaching there, not something you see too often.
This is kind of big, because you can just get dash dance camp by Fox.
What do you mean you don't know? It's Samus on Dreamland.
Fox will just dash dance camp you forever.
Maybe Fountain would be a better option, I guess.
That's what I'm thinking. Fountain?
Yeah.
Fountain or even Battlefield, I feel like.
What the heck? That missile like blew up right above him. It almost looked like it hit him and did nothing. It's so weird.
Yes, this is the only TMG set today, at least on our stream. We're playing, UMD is playing JHU tomorrow.
You might be right, though. Snacks with a big lead right now. It's not going to go down yet.
I never like taking Fox and Falco to Dreamland just because of that. They could be those guys who will dash dance. Oh.
I think he thought he was going to hold the ledge, so he tried to go on stage, but
this is crazy.
Oh my goodness, big damage coming out right now.
Doesn't GMU have Dark Flame? Or did he graduate? I don't see him.
He is on the team, but he's not here today. So
maybe he was busy. That's
not on the roster for the day, yeah. Definitely would have been a very strong option for them.
So. That's why you gotta have 200 players like UMD.
Yeah. Oh, the super wave dash is coming out.
Alright.
Let's go, Samus.
Sometimes you just need some confidence.
Right? Yeah, definitely. Oh my goodness. Platform tricks coming out big time, though. Yeah, this Fox is just running circles around Samus right now.
Yeah, that's exactly the thing. Because Fox has that amazing neutral game. That's
oh my goodness. Wow. And Delaware just continues to expand their huge lead.
This is, like, I don't even know what to say. You're getting the work put on you.
Yeah, definitely. Delaware has just got to be playing so confident with such a big lead right now. So.
But sometimes you just got to clear the nerves. Like, that's what I mean by confidence. Sometimes you just need to taunt, laugh at yourself a little, and you'll play better. Because being on stream and being...
I know that feeling for sure. You might not even need you on. I don't know about that. We'll see. Ooh, storm hit. This should be a kill. Wow, the techs. Alright, that's gotta be.
See, that's a reason why down smash from Samus or Peach is not necessarily a great dash guard.
Yeah.
Because it's really easy to tech because it puts you into the stage.
Ooh, this could be the big turnaround they need, though. Can't quite secure the edge guard. Could up be out of shield. Out of pressure, I guess. Great reaction. Ink's been in control this stock so far.
Yeah? I don't know what Samus in control looks
oh
like.
Oh my goodness! He just charged and fired. Oh, what an angle, though. That was insane. That's gonna be it! Samus dies off the top.
That's rough because you did so much percent and it doesn't matter at all.
Yeah, that's such a good way to kill Samus too, since she's such a slow faller. Are they sending in Hyperflame already? They are.
Alright, so that's
Alex eight, coming out.
8 to 14, I think.
Yep, that's right. We might see, you know, yeah, 8 to 14,
this.
Yep.
I can see this being a decent pick.
I wonder if that's gonna draw out Yuan from him early though. But heck, they might have a pretty deep crew from what I'm seeing here.
I don't want to say too much about Hyperflame. I haven't played him in Melee before.
He is quite
good. He likes to press a lot of buttons. Though
that's also
he
true.
He still plays Falco, I believe, right?
Yep.
His shield pressure, I believe, is not the tightest in the world. He has a lot of buttons, but they're not,
yep,
they're
that's
not
true.
Very tight. So if you feel that, you could actually get like free shield grabs and stuff like that sometimes.
Uh-huh.
And there's that shield. Or, you know, Shadow Shield with Fox. So... that's something I noticed.
This is interesting. We might have seen one game here where stage picking really played a big part in this, you know?
What, the Dreamland pick?
Yeah, I mean, Duck Pimp took a Peach to Battlefield as Captain Falcon, you know?
I mean, that could just be a comfort thing.
I think it was, but still, I feel like he would be better off on Pokemon or...
Pokemon is the thing that comes to mind. FD, maybe, because you can get chain grabbed.
Yeah, that was the
that's
thing
the
I
way,
said
yeah.
about why he might have avoided it. All right. GMU with only 8 stocks left against Delaware's 14. They got a huge hill to climb.
Yeah, as you saw, like, that was one example of what I was actually. That Dare was really high on his shield. That's punishing.
Big tech chase right now.
So if you pay attention to shield pressure, and it's even though they're pressing a lot of buttons, it's not necessarily safe. So, and that's something you need to know versus Falco. Because Falco can't have perfect shield pressure. There's always holes in Falco's shield pressure.
Hyperflame's really hunting for an opening right now, but that could be a stock. Oh my goodness. Snacks just so on point.
Ooh,
great edge guarding.
See, that's the confidence booster. You just
absolutely.
Taunt, and suddenly your opponent is scared. You're feeling good.
Wow.
That could be. That's how we did this to GMU last year.
Oh my goodness.
Talked to the beach.
Snacks.
Yeah. Anyways.
I slept on you far too much. Wow. Sick combos right now.
And I think it's the fear. Like, Hyperflame's slowing down a lot.
Yeah, he's just like. I noticed a lot of the times in this crew battle, GMU players were just fishing for openings, but they just weren't really getting anything. You know, it's that basic stuff you could practice a million times against the CPU, but something is just slightly off when you start playing in tournament.
Right.
Oh, like that.
He was definitely covering him falling down past the platform, but that covers nothing when he goes to the platform.
Oh no, another stock! Wow, Snacks holding it down right now.
Yeah, this is.
To be said. Snack's playing safe, he has no reason to go in.
Do you know who GMU has left?
Baltex, Peach player,
I
believe.
Player. I honestly would have
right,
played.
There you go.
Because Peach is less prone to, you know, like,
yeah.
prone to trade stocks with Fox rather than.
I agree, I'm surprised they didn't save the.
Whereas Falco could be very volatile. If Falco gets shined a couple times, you could be in a huge deficit. But I guess they're going for the all or nothing, you know, hoping that Hyperflame really just puts in the work, but. Didn't work out. Or at least doesn't look like it's working out.
He cannot lose a stack. He's got to hold it down if they have any chance.
Pretty much, unless they have Mewtwo King in the back, actually.
Yeah. Good DI. Oh, man. Oh, no. He just threw it away. That up B was so far into the stage.
And this is...
really just a bad option.
Snacks is probably just going to look for cheese now.
Yep.
I would do that. Because you've done so much work already. Your team is in a great position.
Yeah.
And there's
they have
no
not
risk.
Gotten through their first two players yet, and already GMU is down to their last.
And GMU was, I think, one of the strongest crews last year.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Big upper strengths. Oh no, he's just getting beaten around here. He didn't go for the Nair or the Bear.
Okay. And he doesn't even need cheese now. Just like a back air puts Falcon on stage.
Oh, man.
And you just kill him.
Wow, great recovery from Snacks. Another great angle.
Oh, man, that was probably a faulty back air.
That'll do it. Tense battle, so though.
5-12.
5-12. 7 stock deficit. Can Peach do it?
Hey, if they had snow, they could do it.
Yeah, dude. Shoutouts to Snow. Great stuff in the Smash 4 crew battle. So.
Actually, I don't know. Like,
big credit
so
to him.
No shout to Smash 4, which means I'm probably going to fire shout to Smash 4 immediately afterwards. No.
Oh, wait. No, sorry. Yeah, that's right. Hyperflame's still in, so when I said can Peach do it. Yeah.
How do you do crew battles in like Smash 4? I feel like that's really weird.
They actually did 2-stock crew battles.
Yeah.
That's at Big House, they did 3-stock crew battles. But yeah, 2-stock seems so tiny,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, because like...
Like, that's what we call Blitz crews in
someone
Melee.
Someone can literally solo the other team.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you just 1-stock a couple people, and then, or, you know, 1-stock a person, and then, like, 2-stock a couple people.
Yeah, definitely. It's pretty wild.
Yeah. But I guess, you know, that makes it more exciting, maybe.
Yep.
Do you know who this is?
I believe this is Henry, if I'm not mistaken. Henry? Is this Henry? No? Tag?
Oh, what's your tag?
Squillium. Oh, okay. Alright,
what's going on? Waiting for melee signups?
Here we go. Alright. Oh, we gotta restart the crew battle. Hyperflame cheated.
Wow, 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 DQ'd.
Ah, wow, 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 wow. Okay, so Henry's actually not in their lineup. I got a little mixed up there. So, my bad. So they have Frubins, Squillium, and Yuan left. Very strong lineup.
And they have a Peach, which is a great choice versus Falco, in my opinion. You're up so much,
sure.
you're just trying to not, you know, you're trying to not get, like, bodied, basically.
Yeah, I don't know how much experience Peach has. Actually, if Hyperfine plays against Altec a lot, he might have some good experience in this matchup. So
I guess I wouldn't go to Dreamland because you might get camped. But honestly, I'll just go to Dreamland. You live a long time. You're probably not going to lose more than, like, 2 stocks, even if he plays perfectly.
He just started something big.
Oh, that's...
Chain grabs are coming out. He's not even going for the pummels. This guy is just throwing the bird. Oh, back there. Oh, man, big Nair tech chase.
And, I mean, like, I don't know. Getting chain grabbed is a terrible feeling, and that's probably not helping... Oh, we forgot to change the name for Hyperflame, but whatever.
Oh, sorry about that.
Yeah,
folks.
But Hyperflame, like, that's kind of suck.
He's got a kill, though. Oh, he just had to hit L. That could cost him big time.
I'd be looking for a laser down tilt.
I don't
like down tilt. Yeah.
He had the kill.
He had the kill, and in that situation, I would play it super safe, just... Laser and space down air, or down tilt, sorry, not down air.
Yeah.
The space down tilt, and Peach can't really do anything about that. Maybe fast and air out of shield, but like...
Squillium looking confused right now, trying to unplug his controller. He's not going anywhere, though.
Haven't won yet.
He's got all 12 of his stocks, right? Hyperflame didn't take one.
Yo, that nipples?
Is that nipples?
Is that nipples?
It is nipples.
Is it?
Nipples,
and now our
homie.
Stream is going to get shut down due to nudity.
Due to what?
Due to nudity and change of service.
Yeah, we can't have nipples on stream. It's Twitch policy.
Oh, this is a Peach?
Peach ditto. Yeah.
All right, see you guys. I'm going to go get
stay right there, Bob.
Oh,
stay right there. I think they're going to go for it because they have no reason to wait around unless they're doing hand warmers. Yep,
but I really
they're definitely going at it.
I'm calling both of these schools out. Why don't you want someone on commentary? Just like... Rep your school a little, you know?
I think they just hesitated and then, like, it just didn't happen. I don't know if it was that they didn't want it. Oh, no. Altex. Don't hold down.
You, like, you know, you gotta rip your school. I don't know what else to say. Like,
do you think this is gonna be a big upset if Delaware wins by, like, more than 8 stocks? I feel like it is.
It's an upset when you hear the schools. I don't think it's necessarily an upset based on the teams, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, but I think I just didn't realize how improved Delaware was from last
year.
Yeah,
no, and this is the thing. This is what we want TMG to be.
Oh,
we want
absolutely.
TMG to be
absolutely.
You grow your college scene and, like, literally growing players.
This is great.
This is what we want to see.
Fantastic stuff. Really impressive showing by Delaware. Good back air.
Yeah.
Squillium holding it down. Jimmy's down to 3 stocks.
Um,
I wish I had more insight to offer in this matchup. One thing I do know is that I've seen Nintendo to actually play the matchup a few
how's
times.
This an, okay, so how is this an upset? I say it's an upset in terms of the schools. Because if you watched last year's... Last year's TMG, I feel like GMU looked much stronger last year.
And they also had Dark Flame last year.
They had those Dark Flame. So if you just look at the previous results, you'd think this is an upset. But based on the players, how they're playing right now, you can like obviously say that it's not an upset.
Yeah.
Rather, it may even be expected. Though I do think if they had Dark Flame, it might have been a little closer. I don't know.
Hey, you never know. All techs may call out a miracle here. That's how it starts, man. Only 11 left to go. It doesn't seem that bad.
11 more stitch faces?
Yeah. You just got to take 3 stocks for every one you lose. Yeah, that's all.
Mr. Saturn. Break the shield!
I love that he just went for it, too. Yeah, he's got... Don't shield. He's got nothing to be afraid of. Ooh, okay.
Please shield. I want to see something shield.
Yeah, he got rid of Mr. Saturn. He was like, I got to get back to my my real game here.
I love Mr. Saturn. He's a great character.
He really is. Just a kawaii little alien dude with a bow.
Is he an alien? What?
I don't know, dude.
What?
Dachin, we're in the middle of commentating. Go away. Like, seriously. Quit being a jerk. Oh, they're trying to borrow a controller. Okay.
Walk around. Yeah, walk behind. Ah, sigh. These rude players.
Unbelievable.
These entitled children.
I'd be really curious to see if we actually get a match in TMG that goes longer than 8 minutes. Because it can totally happen, it's totally fine, so...
Oh, there's a bomb.
Oh my goodness, there is a bomb. Can't confirm. Ooh,
oh, wow,
good
shield
though.
Yeah.
Just in time.
Was that a power shield? I couldn't tell. I think it was.
No, otherwise it would have bounced back, right?
No, I don't think bombs don't bounce back like that, do they?
I don't think they explode until they hit something, and I don't think a power shield is considered hitting something. Right? Because, otherwise things would just stop when they hit a power shield.
Peach bombs do weird things, though, don't they?
I don't know, dude. I actually have no idea.
It's also an item, which is kind of different. This needs testing? Lol. Because peach bombs bounce off of stages, don't they?
Mm-hmm.
Peach bombs, normal bombs don't bounce off stages, but peach bombs will bounce off the stage. So we already know they're weird. No, bombs on high won't work. Because peach bombs are different from normal bombs.
Are they really?
Yes, they are. Like, if a normal bomb collides with an object like a stage, it'll explode. A peach bomb will bounce off.
Peach bombs don't bounce off the
Yes,
stage.
They do. I swear to God.
What are you talking about? Get
I
out.
Swear to God.
No way.
Someone tell Tom he's completely wrong, because he's completely wrong.
Alright, I could be. I believe it when I see it.
Tom, you're just not future enough, alright?
Right. Dude, last semester my school, NJIT, versus MSU, and one guy purposely made the game go to 20 plus minutes.
It was
wow.
Awful.
Talk about BM. That's what happens when there's
it
no time,
it reminds
timer, I guess.
Me, I was watching USA versus the World during one of the Apexes, and I was watching
William.
Brawl and Melee, and Brawl was Icy's versus someone, and it definitely was on the same match for like 3 Melee players.
Yeah.
Like, I would just go back, still stalling.
Was that like the cringeworthy year where everybody wanted Isaiah?
Huh?
That was so bad, dude.
It might have been. Yeah, I don't know.
It's like, what is going on?
I think it was the year where Mike Hayes threw it for the US.
Oh, God. Jeez.
Why'd
you put in Mike Hayes?
In Brawl? I don't know.
Oh, in Brawl.
He
okay.
took like a single stock and then like lost it.
He was a pretty good Marth player back in Brawl, right?
They definitely bounce off. Oh my god, top bodied. Oh.
Alright, confirmed. Widowwood now.
Yep.
Shout outs to Widow, speaking of crew battles.
Am I human? Somebody get me off. I'm too much.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, that's okay.
Alright.
One stock to 9.
Shout outs to Norway. I'll definitely hit you up one of these days. Widow's from Norway, right?
What?
Or is it Denmark? I always get them confused.
Oh yeah!
He's that guy.
Yeah, he's that guy. What's up, that guy?
He was left and couldn't make it, so I'm on the crew guy. He played good too.
Wait, why is he here?
For TMG, dude, it's hype. Crew battles are always hype. I feel like Europe understands how to like respect hype things more than the US does. So.
Little England definitely was in our stream chat once, just like, hi guys.
Little England? I haven't heard that tag in ages.
And he was like, yeah, I might be going to UMD next year.
What?
I don't see him though. So
how old is that guy?
It was, I don't know, but he said it last year.
Grad student? Okay. GMU is still in it. All Texas staying alive. All
right, so this is easy. Like, if it was me, this would be completely easy.
Yeah. Easy mode, though.
See, this is...
Oh, oh, you're not even Captain Von Riesel. Why don't you put your tag right there?
No, that's not on this one. It's
put
on
it?
The other one.
Oh, psych. Like, so okay. Got it. Delaware. So Delaware is sending in their not U1 player, so it must be for Benz, the Sheik. So
that's
F-R-U-B-E-N-Z.
A good
choice,
for sure.
Why don't you type that in?
F-R-U-B-E-N-Z. That's it. Sheik, I think, definitely the better choice.
And Delaware is at 8 stocks, right?
1-8, yes.
Help me up, Bob. Alright.
So, yeah, so Peach Sheik, or Sheik Peach is definitely slight Sheik favor, I think, in Melee. In NTSC. And Sheik, I feel like, well, at worst trade.
Non-UR player, yeah.
At worst trade.
Sorry, Wump, I just don't know their team that well.
Unless you're Kalamazoo playing against Kirby Kaze in that one set. Lamau.
Was that the one that KZ won, or?
No, the one, there was a... Kirby Kaze took 2 stocks without I think he took 3 stocks without taking any damage.
Wow, dude. What? Just happened?
Anyways.
I guess they're not going FD.
He accidentally SD'd. She gets hit, so.
You dingus.
Shout out to that video. In the comments, you see Keizu saying the match starts at 1:30 when the first game ended at like 1:20.
Oh, that's amazing, dude. That's really funny.
I love KZ. Anyways, unrelated. But yeah, Sheik, I feel like, does not
oh,
really
what
get
the heck? They switched sides.
Oh my god, who does that? Oh, that's just whatever.
Well, you got the
you
idea.
You guys know that.
All Texas the Peach. Three Benz is the Sheik.
But yeah, whereas I could see Peach zero to deathing Falco, I don't see it being as likely with Sheik. Sheik can trade pretty well with Peach. And he'll, I feel like it's hard
right,
to
Altex, time for Beast Mode to engage. Let's go, buddy.
He's doing pretty well. If you can get Sheik off stage on FD, edge guarding is honestly pretty flowcharty.
Yeah. Alright, good dash dance there.
And this should be dead. It's just follow the flowchart.
Nice.
Make sure it says.
I like the
yeah, that should be.
Hover through in the air.
Oh,
oh no. Some very crucial edge guards.
You could have just sat on ledge too, because Sheik's poof doesn't have a reappearing hitbox.
Yep. That ain't Smash 4.
But he has taken more now. But he's taken a decent amount of damage.
Good edge guard. Good edge guard. Sweet, the confidence.
Oh, they're almost up too. Oh god, this. Oh, this is Armada!
Oh, big combos coming out. I
want
to see this go to the final game.
Me too.
I want to see Altex go crazy. Okay, holding it down. Sweet, taunting again. Leveling up with every taunt.
Yep. That's probably a dash tag.
Interesting use of tilt.
That's probably a dash tag. Whenever I have to with Peach, it's because I tried to dash tag.
Oh. Is he dead? Oh.
Oh, he is.
Wow, oh this God. Could be a 4 stock. Oh, the he taunted again. Can you believe it? The confidence is...
Oh,
that's it.
Yeah.
Congratulations to University of Delaware. Coming out very strong.
The stitch there, though?
Winning by 5 stocks.
All right, I got to go.
Good stuff to them.
What time is it right now? 7:30. Okay. We're going to switch this back to PM, do some PM bracket, and then... we'll be running Melee Bracket soon after.
All right, guys. Thank you so much for joining us for this Melee Games crew battle. If you want to social media up the Melee Games, they're on all the social medias, so go check it out. Just, like, search for Melee Games or something. I don't know. It's like, why do people tell you to follow at the Melee Games? If you just Google, like, the Melee Games,